when Deep Blue beat Garry Kasparov back in 1997, that was the time when people started to realise that artificial intelligence may not be that far away.
Professor Taylor?
Yes?
Does Deep Blue have anything to do with, you know?
I knew someone was going to ask about that eventually. Despite it not being finished, I'll show it to you now. This is Xavier, my very own artificial intelligent robot. I made it as a device to help people who have suffered emotional or traumatic events in their lives.
Mr. T, is it able to talk?
Not yet, but it can respond to questions. One beep for yes, two beeps for no, and three beeps for maybe. I'll start off asking a question, and then you guys can feel free to ask whatever you like. Some of the answers may even be helpful for exams later this year. Xavier, which is better, alternating current or direct current?
Would we have cyborgs in 10 years?
Did Nicki Minaj invent the radio?
Mr. T, why haven't you put it on the market yet?
I'm not interested in making money from Xavier. I prefer to keep my device more personal and relative to the people that I know.
Professor Taylor, is there a personal reason why you built him? My dad has seen you at the hospital with your mother. I was wondering.
Yes, my mother has Alzheimer's and I built Xavier for her. Don't forget that after exams, next term we'll be studying the origins of the video games industry, with the main topic of focus being Nolan Bushnell. I'll see you all next term and good luck with your exams. Also, Theodore and Samantha, don't forget to hand your papers in by the end of term, by the end of tomorrow, or on the very first day of next term. Come in.
Professor Taylor.
Dr. Hartnell.
I have some unfortunate news.
Hi, Ma. Sorry I'm late. Got stuck in really bad traffic again. But I've got good news. I finally found a voice for Xavier. It's taken me 4 years, but I've finally got the voice. Being your birthday today, tonight I'm going to watch Mary Poppins, and that'll be a remembrance that you've been gone for 4 years. Well, Mum, I need to go, so I'll see you again. Bye-bye.
Thank you.
Hey, what time is it?
Nearly 1 o'clock. It's late.
He can't be much longer, surely.
He'll be here soon. It's not someone who breaks his promises.
This place is a dump. Are you sure he'd like it? Surely he'd want something better than this.
As long as it's his roof over his head, he'll take anything. Look, he may be having trouble trying to fit in, but at least he's self-aware.
I do like a guy who's self-aware.
Hello.
Hey.
You seem cheerful.
Yes, I can't wait to see my... new home. Is this the place?
Yeah. What's wrong with it?
Nothing's wrong with it. It's a perfectly fine building, but it's, how do I put it nicely? A little bit creepy.
See, I told you he wouldn't like it.
Look, it was the best I could do. Many of the old places like these got torn down in home development. Luckily, this one was saved.
Well, it may not be the home of King Charles, but it'll have to do. Come on, let's go.
Are you coming, Jake?
I just thought, you know, I could stay here and be on the lookout.
Come on, Jake. Are you afraid of going into the lion's den?
Come on, Jake.
Fine.
Don't worry, Jake. If anything goes wrong, I've got my trusty umbrella.
Weird and it looks disease-ridden.
Well, it doesn't look that bad, it just looks a bit, run down and dusty.
A place like this would be perfect for hiding from the cops.
Hey, at least there's one positive.
Sorry if it's not up to your standards. I've been looking for months for a place for you.
It's alright. You tried your best. We'll find another place.
Alright, I'm sick of this place. I'm hungry, let's go home. Hey guys, I found something.
What is it?
I don't know. Open it, find out.
Well, you're the one who found it. I think you should open it.
Well, yeah, but... oh, why don't you open it?
Open it, Jake. What if it's a hit?
You really know how it And it's furry. You can take it out.
Okay.
The stuffed toy.
It looks narrow.
Sad. Being all alone in this building, not being played with. Interesting.
What? Mr. Taylor? Wait a minute. Oh, yeah.
You can talk!
Of course I can talk. Oh, yeah. You mean to destroy me?
No. My name is Belisarius, and these are my friends, Artemis and Jake.
Hi.
My name is Xavier. I was built on November 23rd, 2017. I was built to help Professor Taylor's mother, Mary, to help cope with emotional stress and trauma from her Alzheimer's.
Weird.
Well, looks like we found something interesting from this place. Come on, let's go. I think we've had enough here. All right, let's go.
So, that way you're here, Mr. Belisarius?
Yes, I've been here for a few months. That's how I came across these two fine friends.
Yeah, Mr. Belisarius was helping me deal with some pricks from my school. Yeah, and we've been friends ever since.
I came across Belisarius when he was trying to steal from a craft store. Remember that?
I was desperate. Besides, you would have done the same thing if you wore my shoes.
I see. So where do you live now?
I live in some bushes in this park here. I used to live in an old bungalow next to a supermarket, but they got torn down for parking spaces.
Sorry to hear that. It'd be okay if I stayed with you, Mr. Belisarius.
The more the merrier. But you'll have to get used to my frugal lifestyle since I don't have any cash or food on me most of the time.
I'm a robot. All I need is just a general fix-up now and then, and if my circuits go wrong. But have you got any oil with you?
Why do you need oil?
I've been shut down for so many years. I would like some to fix my joints after years lying in a small box.
Hey, who's that?
It's Mr. Taylor. Mr. Taylor, over here.
Right, hand it over.
Mr. Taylor, they're good. Don't hurt them.
What the fuck?
Hey, get back here.
Who was that?
I don't know. I think he's going to destroy Xavier. What is that?
It's a tracking device.
Brilliant. You two go after him. I'll catch up with you guys.
Yep, we'll see you later.
Wait, stop!
Don't come any closer or I'll shoot.
Who are you? Why did you steal Xavier?
I'm not telling you. You only want him to make money.
Don't hurt me. I'll do anything you want.
Shut up, Xavier.
Don't destroy Xavier. Are you Mr. Taylor?
My name is Taylor. Andre Maxwell Taylor. And I'm a scientist and I created Xavier 14 years ago to help my mother who was sick with Alzheimer's. But the details of Xavier were leaked into the internet and all the big electronic companies wanted to get those so they could make millions out of my creation. So I've hidden them away so that they couldn't do that.
Professor Taylor, I'm sorry to hear that. I really am. I'm really sorry.
Mr. Belisarius, help, please. Don't let him destroy me. I want to live. Help me, Mr. Belisarius. I want to live.
Look, don't destroy Xavier, please. Please, I beg you.
If you know about him, everyone will know about him.
Okay, Balasaurus.
Yeah, I'm okay. This Professor Taylor guy is not as bad as I thought.
Okay, so now you all know about Xavier. What am I going to do now?
Listen, Professor Taylor, it's not Xavier's fault. It's those companies. Listen, you can have a fresh start now. They won't track you down anymore.
He possibly could start on you.
Listen, do it for Mary. Do it for your mother. Let Xavier live.
I suppose Xavier could have a fresh start with you guys. Away from me and away from companies who want to exploit him and make money. Tell me, what are your names?
Well, I'm Belisarius.
I'm Artemis.
I'm Jake.
I'm Artemis.
Artemis?
Here's your gun.
Oh, thank you.
Jake, sorry I pushed you.
It's fine, Jake.
Belisarius.
Belisarius. Okay. Well, look after Xavier. I'm sure he'll do everything that he's been programmed to do.
I hope he will.
Okay. So it's a fresh start for him, and it's a fresh start for me.
Who was that guy?
His name was Professor Taylor, Andre Maxwell Taylor. He built Xavier here for his mother, but unfortunately, his mother died before he could complete Xavier for her. That's when all those companies tried to cash in on Xavier.
Disgusting. Have you ever lost a relative?
Even if I have, it's been a long time. I can't remember anything about my family. Even if I did find them, or if I found them, they probably wouldn't recognize me. We wouldn't recognize each other. That's if my family is still here, if you know what I mean.
That's sad. A creation created from sadness. Sorry if we can't find you a new home today.
It's alright. You know the old saying, if you don't succeed, try again.
Don't worry, we'll find something.
I'll miss me creator, but I'll understand that he had to move on.
Well, that's just part of life, Xavier. Happens all the time.
Hello? Really? Okay, cool. We'll see you in a bit. That was Jake. He said he's found something.
Found what?
Hey, guys.
Hey.
Well, what do you think?
Jake, this is amazing. How did you find this place?
I found this while you guys were off chatting.
Jake, it looks amazing. Artemis, what do you think?
It's in decent condition. Okay. It's perfect.
I know. Well, Belisarius, what do you think of your new home?
It's brilliant, isn't it? It's absolutely brilliant. I wouldn't have been able to do this without the help of you two. Well, Xavier, what do you think?
Don't you mean what does the box say?
It's been 14 years. People need to learn to move on, okay? It's dead.
It looks fantastic, Mr. Belisarius. I can't wait to go inside.
Yeah, me too.
Well, me and Jake are going on now. See you guys later.
See you too.
Okay, see ya.
Bye.
Oh, who has the perfect class with it?
Come on, Xavier. Let's head inside.
Mr. Belisarius, what are we going to do for food?
Don't worry. I got some cash on me after an eating contest I won. I think we'll survive on that for the next few weeks. I've been through many obstacles, Xavier, but I think I'm able to have a fresh start. And also, just call me Belisarius from now on. Rufus Belisarius. You know, Xavier, I think we're going to get on quite well. Come on, let's head home.
Kicked it over the fence and broke a silly no more tune.